Welcome back to Pathologic Classic HD. We've just spoken with the Canes, and they told us what happened to Simon Kane, the person that I originally came to this town to see to try to convince other people about the validity of our research in trying to defeat mortality. So that's very unfortunate, and we really need to find out what happened to Simon Kane. So the person I need to speak to now is the last person that saw him alive, basically, the last person that visited Simon Kane, which is Isidor Barak, who lives all the way over here on the other side of town. I don't know if I want to visit all these places along the way. Probably not. No, I don't think I will. Because time is always ticking, and I want to make sure I get to Isidor. I think things might get creepy at night. I'm not sure. So let's head off to do that. But before that, let's speak to these two people. See what they have to say. Perhaps they have more tips. The town is small and rather unexceptional, isn't it? But there are all kinds of people here. The simple folk, and the more remarkable ones. The former will tell you more than they know. The latter know way more than they're ever going to let out. Keep a close eye on them. Your victory depends on it. And who are these remarkable people? There are 20-something of them, easily distinguished by their lodgings or their presence. They're called many names. The Bound, the Faded, the Adherents, the Gobo's Taggler, the Town Circle. Simon preferred their company to any other. Why? Because it is they that will decide the fate of this town. Don't be distracted by the fact that some of them look insignificant or disreputable. They will earn their worth. You just give them time. They're the most important joints of the town. Why are you telling me all this? Each day, one of them will try death by the tooth. Each will put their life at risk. And each one that dies is important. Some of them may take the keys to victory, to the grave. Mind that the keys are yours, while the grave is theirs. Others will do the opposite. Don't waste your chance to condemn someone who may get in your way. Okay, so if they die, then I might lose the ability to do what I came here to do. And don't be afraid to condemn someone who might get in my way. Okay. How do you know what's helpful and what gets in the way? Okay, alright. Dropping you more hints would be cheating. Shutting up now. Allow me to conclude, then. Each bound you save will influence the finale of your adventure. Each of them has their own goals and motives. It may so happen that those who seek a different ending survive. And then, well, you've been warned. Everybody has their own goals and motives. But some of them might seek a different ending than I do. And if they survive to the end, then it sounds like they might be able to, perhaps, enact their favored end. They might get what they want instead of what I want, if their goals differ from mine and they stay alive. Okay, I'll take that into account, and we'll be careful. And what about you? There is something in particular we feel the urge to warn you about. When you speak to the Bound, please choose your words carefully. Do not worry. You will easily be able to make out what kind of a person is standing before you, an observant man that you are. So use that skill when dealing with the Bound. Some of them are indeed worth insulting, whereas others need to be treated with utmost respect. I don't really like either of these options. The bottom one just isn't true. If I'm ever talking to somebody, it won't be for personal gain? Well, no, that can't be true. But I also don't want to say I have no idea what you're talking about, because I do. I guess I'll go with that, though. Every line you utter will have consequences. News spreads rapidly around here. If you spoil your reputation in one place, you'll have to reap what you've sown in another. Restore your good name in the south, and you'll receive a warmer welcome in the north. They will heed every word you say, and you'll be rewarded. Not by means of money, I hope. A handful of money. It's not a dialogue fee, don't get me wrong. Never refuse to take small sums of money from the bound. That would not belittle you in any fashion, but would rather demonstrate that you appreciate the local customs. All right, I'll keep local customs in mind. So if they offer me money from the... if the bound offer me money, take it. Understood. Okay, let's start our jaunt across town. Oh, but you know what? First, let's just confirm what I believe to be true, and that's that all the buildings... so the red ones are, like, super important buildings that you can enter. The brown ones are just normal buildings, and it looks like the tan ones are indeed shops, because this is a tan building on the map. It looks like they sell clothing. Let's just double check that and make sure. Good day. Lovely place you have here. Jesus Christ, this is a depressing store. They don't even say a word. Alright, so my inventory is on the right, their inventory is on the left. What do they sell? A drapery! Used for moving around in infected areas in order to prevent accidental tactile contact with infected particles and surfaces. Single-use item. Thrown away before entering a building. Okay. I don't want any of these things. This is really the entire stock of the store? You're telling me this person only sells... a drapery, two needles, and five units of kerosene? How do you stay in business? Good day. Okay, so yeah, let's just head east. Let's go to the bridge here, let's keep going. I guess I'm not gonna stop, for the most part. Unless something catches my eye. Let's take in the local sights. Let's take in the depressing sights of everything being yellow and sickly looking. Oh, just filled my empty bottles. Okay, well, wait a minute. Let's actually stop here. This has caught my eye. What is this place? Oh, that's a loaf of bread, and I think that's milk. Oh, what time is it? 9 a.m., I've got plenty of time. I'm seriously tempted to take that, but that looks like an offering. This seems like kind of a religious place, or a ceremonial place, and that looks like an offering. I'm pretty sure it'd be very bad to take that. Let's not. There's another statue over there. Is this place marked on the map? Yeah. Strange place. There's nothing in there. A rectangular marble room. Huh. Okay, across the bridge we go. Time doesn't pass super fast, so I've got some time, but I don't want to dawdle too long. Please don't break my legs going down. Please don't break my legs. Okay. Ooh, a child. Hi. It's creepy the way they're just staring at me. But, I think I want to trade with the child, because if I remember right from the description of, one of my items... Needle, needle, needle. There you are. A large sewing needle. Such needles may be of interest to children, because local tradition prohibits them from owning any sharp objects. Yeah, so I think it's a trade item for children. Let's see. I've heard so much about you. Oh! Calling her, I can call her Pumpkin? That sounds so creepy. What's in your pockets, Pumpkin? Sounds like a freaking serial killer. I've heard a lot about you too. That's not true. But should I say that anyway? No. You look cheerful. That's a good sight. Oh, no, come back. Oh, what's in your pockets, Pumpkin? That might be the, trade. We might start the trade. Presents. Uncle Bachelor. Do you want to trade presents? Why not? Sure. You have... Oh, you've got painkillers. Okay. Ah. Yeah, so I believe the children don't actually take money. Because I have a bunch of money, but I believe they only barter. And it looks like the price of this is 2 items. And of course, this only counts as 1 item, because it is only 1 item. So I guess I would need 2 needles to trade for it. But that would be so worth it. Some painkillers for 2 needles? That's a great trade. But not gonna work for now. So let's make sure I loot any, like... Oh, actually, there could be a needle in here. Eh, empty bottle. Yeah, loot any trash cans and stuff like that. I need to be a scavenger right away, because trust me, things will get tight. More youths. Hello, kid. Hey, you. Go mess with us. We know a thing or two about life. Why are you so bristled up? It has begun. A crushing blow to the soul and a halves is being prepared. There are almost 70 dogheads. No one will escape their doom. Who are the soul and a halves and the dogheads? The soul and a halves have a soul and a half, and the dogheads have dogheads. As you can see, it's a clash of ideas, a matter of principle. It's an us or them situation. There will be no mercy. Are we talking about gangs here? I'm guessing those are gangs. You've got some fierce games. A game to some, destiny to others. I hope you avoid manslaughter. Hold on, let's trade. Let's barter, lad. I have a lot of curious things. Ah, same thing as the other kid. What about you? Wow, that's startling. What's wrong with you? What? Nothing? Let's trade. Ooh, you've got ammo. Price of that is 1. So I can buy 1 round. 1 round of ammunition for a needle. Yes, bullets are very scarce in this game. And yes, if you're wondering, you can get guns. You can get guns, you can get ammunition, you can shoot people. But you want to be really careful with your ammo, and of course, really careful with who you shoot. Okay, where am I even going? Still going east. Let's head a little bit north, northeast, so I can hit that bridge up there. Hello, what do you have to barter? Aren't you a lively gal? Shall we barter, perhaps? More ammunition. Isn't it funny that children are prohibited from having sharp objects, but they just have tons of ammunition and painkillers? It's creepy. Now hold on, let's see what she's so happy about. We've almost caught the unseen cat. Wanna come see it? I can say I'm allergic to cats. Definitely. Take me to it. Should I save my game in case the unseen cat claws out my eyes or something? Are you taking me to the cat? Or what? Is she just not even taking me to the cat? I thought you wanted to show me the unseen cat. Is that the joke? The unseen cat is unseen and it doesn't exist? Pfft, see ya. Oh, this is one of my favorite places. It's so strange. Let's climb to the top. The sound of screaming babies when you come to the top of this structure. And there's no way this structure could even exist in the real world, right? This is impossible. This whole thing would collapse. There's no support. It's so strange and otherworldly. It doesn't make any sense. Okay, what time is it? Oh, it hasn't even been an hour. It's about 10 a.m. We're fine. Bridge is this way. I think we're almost there, actually. Just keeping an eye out for trash cans and stuff like that. Like this one. Ooh! A razor. I could definitely sell that to... My first thought when finding a razor is I can definitely sell that to a child somewhere. Oh, I'm such a good person. Pretty sure I'm going the wrong way here, but I really want to see if there's anything in this can. Ooh! A watch? Another empty bottle? Sweet. Okay, yeah, where am I? Okay, hold on. If I remember right, it's kind of tricky to get to this house. Because there's fences everywhere here, so you can't just go through, and I don't think you can go through the alleyway. I think I've got to go, like, all the way around or something. Let's go north and see if we can get around that way. I just remember having lots of trouble getting to the house, though. But it's possible they've changed it in the remastered version. Oh wait, I can just go through here? Oh, I can't just go through here. Pretty sure the door is on the other side though, yeah. Hold on, there's some cans over here. Those people look so freaking creepy. You see this guy around sometimes. He looks so damn creepy, that, like, maniacal grin. He kind of reminds me of Max Payne, too, for some reason. A little bit. Okay, yeah, we gotta go around this building here. There we go, that wasn't so hard. Bodyguards? twins. A foul murder occurred here this night. No unauthorized access allowed. Inspecting the crime scene is strictly forbidden until further notice. Jesus Christ, so not just Simon's dead. Isidor too. Who was killed? Well, you're not a local, sir, so you're unlikely to understand the loss we've suffered. Isidor Barak. A great surgeon. A benefactor to us all. And an all-around skilled doc. An outstanding man. Beloved and well-respected by us locals. Does it really always have to take the very best? What a foul time to live in. I knew him. I'm a doctor, too. Whoever killed our only doc must surely be looking to get us all killed. Isidor could cure anything. He also knew how to make cuts or incisions, because he was a warden. He knew his lines all right. Like I said, it all makes sense. Whoever killed Simon took Isidore's life too. And this is merely the beginning. Only the beginning? What makes you so sure? See, this murderous deal is all mysterious. There was a talon stuck in the victim's chest. Go ahead, bend your arm at the elbow, good sir. Yeah, like that. Here you go. That's how long it was. It broke off. There was dust on the floor, for the deceased had been a renowned stepwalker, and the dust was all covered in hoof steps and, like, traces of a sharp bone, I guess. As if someone was using a walking stick around there. I'm telling you, it's her. The Shabnok Adir. The Clay Man-Eater. Hmm? Shabnok Adir? What, some sort of like a creature that uses a walking stick and kills people? I want to inspect the building. Oh, wait a minute, I just realized. There's a little avatar in the bottom left. It's another, like, ragdoll dummy, just like some other person I talked to before, but the last one I saw was smiling, and this one's frowning. Yeah, I want to inspect the building. We've been assigned to this post by Alexander, the head of the Suvorov family. His house is in decline right now, but it's still powerful and very much respected. For it is they that's been responsible for maintaining worldly order and public safety in the town since olden days. Please kindly address your concerns to him. That's their rod. You just take that road up there and get to the Cape. As for me, I'm not authorized to let you in. You should have said so from the start. Oh, that's not too far away. Alright, let's go speak with them. So this will be my first encounter with another powerful family. And, are they burning a woman alive? What the fuck is going on here? Did she just die? Where did she go? Huh? Where did she go? She literally disappeared. Couple dead bodies. Ooh, a gun. Okay. Where's the woman, though? What the fuck was that? Wow. That's a really good find. You don't find a lot of weapons or ammo. Okay, so they're burning a woman. She looked like, I don't know, like a dryad or something. Her clothes were very strange. And I'm really still wondering why she just literally disappeared. Did she die and then her model despawned or something? Was that supposed to happen or was that a bug? I don't know. But look at these growths around here. It's like roots. Massive roots. where are the roots coming from? And this thing looks like a bone. Bizarre. Let's go ahead and equip my gun, actually. If I do need to kill somebody, which I hope I don't, but if I do, I'd rather have my gun equipped than my scalpel. Okay, where am I now? I am going totally the wrong way. Let's get through here to the street and then go right. Here, right? Yep. Was it you burning that woman there in the crowd? Oh, how ferocious Mother Nature is, for 'tis her wrath that has to be withstood. Oh, friend, if only I could wet my whistle, I'd gladly give you anything on earth in exchange for a gulp of chilly spring water. Oh, when he said wet my whistle, I was assuming they were drunk and they wanted alcohol, but they just want water. Okay, how about we barter? Bandage. Costs 5. So it's gonna cost 5 of my water bottles for 1 bandage. I don't need a bandage right now. Also, this dude's face is so freaking creepy, I really don't want to trade with him. Oh, dead end? Yeah, dang it. Stupid fences. Here we go. This is the same plant I saw at the Kane family residence. What is it, and why is it so common? Hello? That's a very creepy picture.
It is as if my temples were pierced with needles. Do something.
I'll try my best.
It's true. The girl has proven that she's a saint, not a killer.
The only proper way for a duel to end is with the death of one of the fighters. That's what battles are supposed to be. Any conflict that has two sides inevitably turns into a battle of good and evil. I never liked black and white mentality. I'm not speaking metaphorically or metaphysically. I'm talking about a very particular battle. You are one of the combatants, Bachelor Dankovsky. Do you favor good or evil? That's too vague a question. I cannot be more coherent. Details distort the core essence. They devalue the words. What? Choose my words carefully when speaking with important people, so let's not imply that you might be delirious. What you're saying is it will be I who is to adjust the details along the way, right?
The wheel of my fortune has touched me in a dream.
You are a brave man, Bachelor Denkovsky. Why? This fight is very unlikely to end in your favor. Does a clay and bone man-eater leave traces of the kind you've witnessed? It's only a spell, an illusion. They just prefer to see it this way. It makes it easier for them. So you know the details of my fight in advance. If you don't point at the killer by nightfall, then the killer will strike you down as well. You simply won't be able to recognize them. You won't notice them crawling up to you. Somehow you'll be very surprised upon seeing their face, and that will leave you paralyzed. How do you know all this? I'm clairvoyant. What's the nature of your visions? This should not be your primary concern at the moment. You should concern yourself with the number of minutes you have left, and that number is dwindling. I don't throw predictions around. Others will tell you how often they have come true. Do heed my words. Fine. Are you not the person I'm supposed to speak to? Oh, I guess there's multiple wings in this place. I went to the wrong one. She really said if I don't basically find the killer by midnight today, I'll be dead? Seriously? I better make some permasaves in case I like really mess this up and have to go back. Okay, so it said it should be here. Is there a door here? No. Ah, here we go. It must be you, right? Maybe.
This Horuspex is trying to prove his innocence. It's a no-go.
So, I finally get to see you. Yes, you really do look like a messenger of sorrowful times. In any case, welcome to the Rod. Our meeting is quite significant in a way. Facing the changes with open eyes and taking their first blow is my duty. Do you think we're on the verge of an especially unhappy era? No grim events have clouded our existence since last summer. The country has cured its war wounds. Commercial communications have been repaired. Astrologists expect nothing ill. Do you hold astrologists' opinions in high regard? Interesting. There doesn't seem to be an option to say no about whether we hold astrologists' opinions in high regard. Let's just try to be respectful, simple, before we gain more information. Don't want to piss them off. Sometimes I have to. Are you an astrologist? I am a ruler. Astrology can be very curious. But I cannot allow it to influence my decisions. I have to act according to factual circumstances. Would you agree? Definitely.
The rabble is completely out of control. They must have been bottling up their lowly instincts for quite some time.
So you've come to meet with Simon, haven't you? What can I do for you now? I was actually invited by Isidor, so I came to meet with him first and foremost. But now it turns out that he's been murdered, yes. Looks like the murderer is always one step ahead of you, doesn't it? The same one that took Simon's life, too. At least, that's the conclusion suggested by the information at my disposal. Same pattern, same signature. Were there any traces? Look, I haven't been there myself. I'm quite content with interrogating suspects, especially since we already know who we're after. You can join the hunt, by the way. I can describe his features. Wait, his features? but the people described... the people at the door, or I guess the person at the door, described it as a her. The clay man-eater. Who is it, then? You wouldn't believe it. His own son. The fellow came back after being away for quite a while. His father had sent him to study surgery when he was but a greenhorn. Quite a lot he has learnt, huh? A wandering scholar turned evil to the bone. All of that just to grab the inheritance. So, what, did Isidor leave a fortune? I have no idea yet. His belongings are being evaluated as we speak. It's not about money, though. The steppe people's idea of heirship still comes with those ancient connotations, tribal ethics. The next of kin not only inherits things, they inherit knowledge, fate, power. Such motive is incompatible with a student of medicine, in my mind. It's in their blood. Oh well, the outlaw will show his true colors soon enough when we catch him. He'll explain the motive himself. How did you find him? In all honesty, it's hard to explain that to an outsider like you. Do you believe in such a thing as clairvoyance, Bachelor? I'm gonna go with I do. Well, you should get to know my wife, then. Or better yet, those who have already had opportunities to witness the power of her prophecies. Former doubters, first and foremost. Rationalists. She's got something to say to you, too, by the way. So your wife called out Isidor's son specifically? Not specifically, no. But it all adds up. And the circumstances of Simon's death make you wonder, too. Isidor's son arrived here last night. The timing speaks against him. It even matches the time it takes to get from the crucible to Isidor's house. That's not enough. I'll have to take the investigation into my own hands. Is there anyone who can be of help to me, apart from your wife? There are very few good analysts in our town. Everyone is more or less superstitious here. Except for one Yulia... what is that? I'm not gonna try that. Yulia. Perhaps. A most level-headed and reasonable person. The only person to remain skeptical about Katerina's talents, too. Without a shadow of a doubt, she has her own picture of events. She always does. Exactly the person I need. That's them. Also very close by, thankfully. Anything more to say to you?
The outcome was to be expected, I'm afraid. Simon was doomed.
Who are the people guarding Isidor's house? Those are volunteer patrolmen. We usually keep around 20 of them, but I've increased the number recently to 100 and a half or so. Wait, you've increased it from 20 to 100 and a half? That's a lot. Why do you need so many? There's unrest in the termitary. If I weren't certain that Isidor has been murdered by his son, I would even consider the crime to be politically motivated. Isidor was preparing to take over the kin and become its leader. At least according to the information I have. Isidor is trying to take over the kin. What is the kin? The steppe people who work in the abattoir. Many of the factory workmen. An ignorant, patriarchal pile that hasn't changed much since the Stone Age. They look human enough, but if you look closer, they're just beasts. Believe me when I'm telling you that I'm not snobbish in the slightest, but there's good reason to call them that. I see. I don't think you're aware of the fact that Isidor came to me last night, just after he had returned, and warned me that there were some ominous events ahead of us. I took that as an unofficial warning about his upcoming takeover. So you took measures? Evidently. I've mobilized the patrols. I see what you're implying, Bachelor, but I'm not insane. Engineering Isidor's murder. As a matter of fact, a strong independent kin under Isidor's rule would have been way more useful to me. Really? Why? Because that would weaken the power of the Honorable Vladislav Olgimsky, who's pocketed the economy of the whole town. He'd rather see the kin as a dumb and speechless herd. And come to think of it, well, I'm sure you understand where I'm going with this. This is precisely what Georgie warned me about. That just ends the conversation.
My chest hurts. Can it be conscience?
Okay, let's go speak with his wife again and see if she has anything more to tell me.
Simon, to tame his impertinence, Earth had disgorged a monster from deep within its bowels.
Oh, the torment. I can't bear it. Why don't you take some painkillers then? It just ends the conversation?
I'm afraid.
Wait a minute, hold on. Didn't it say before something like, just offer somebody painkillers? How do I do that? Can I put painkillers just...
I'm afraid I'm of little oh God. Use now.
I just took them. I just took the painkillers. No. Dear God, no. I thought you'd have to double-click it or something. I just clicked it once and it took the painkillers. I'm assuming they just have to be in your inventory. I don't think you can just put them in your hands.
It is as if my temples were pierced with needles. Do something.
Do you also think Simon Kane's death was unnatural? No, not at all. How could someone who had absorbed all our blood not die? A single man cannot handle that. There are limits to a living being's vitality, and there are limits to the world's patience. Wait, absorbed all our blood? What are you talking about? Absorbed? Simon used to drink human blood? Simon transformed our town into a single whole, a living being. He was the heart, and we were the blood running through the town's veins. We radiated his light, and that's why we used to shine so brightly. The bound are actually bound to Simon. And what about the limits to the world's patience? What do you mean by that? I cannot elaborate upon this. I can only feel it. As if this was a heavenly wrath. The payback for all that he had done. The world couldn't stand it anymore. But the world must have made someone its weapon, right? Who is to blame for his death? Even if someone did have something to do with it, is that person worth blaming? Most likely, they didn't even realize they were killing someone. Yes, that is how it was. Now I see it very clearly. Oh yeah, you're clairvoyant. What a way to end the conversation.
Simon.
Look at just the construction of this building. It's so bizarre. Have you noticed how wrong this building is? This is obviously the front of the building, right? Isn't this? Hold on, let me see if there's actually a way inside from the other side. I just want to point out how bizarre the geography is. Or not the geography, but the construction of these buildings. Okay, no, I guess this is... Maybe this is the front? It suppose this is the front. But if you look at the size of this place outside compared to the size inside, it feels like there's tons of missing space. Like, look at this. This is fairly small. It's just these two rooms. And it just seems like the size inside doesn't nearly take up all of the room that would be available inside of this building. As if there's massive amounts of unused space. It just doesn't feel right. And look at how small this room is. This room's tiny. There's no way those two doors, the three rooms that you can get to through those two doors, take up all the space inside this building. There's just no way. It's creepy. Alright, well, I think that's a pretty good place to end the episode. So we've discovered sort of what's happened to Isidor, at least in the sense that he was killed. Don't know exactly by what or how. And the next thing to do is go speak with Yulia. See if she can tell us a little bit more about what's happened with Isidor. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.